Joining me now is the 16th Archbishop of Baltimore, Archbishop William Lori. I'm remembering just a year ago, our Holy Week and our Easter looked so different as we were celebrating masses in empty churches just to live stream and get some message out and some celebration out. The church has learned a lot and we've come a long way. What do you think we've really gained by that experience of this past year?
I think we are looking to the hope, the new life, the joy that the resurrection imparts to us. And I think we are looking to experience in ourselves and in our parish communities and the larger society a kind of resurrection. But I also think we learned a lot this year. I think we learned that we are more resilient than we think we are. Certainly true when I talk to moms and dads who have found a way to keep their families safe and happy. I think about our schools, our Catholic schools, that have been open since August. I think about how our parish communities so quickly pivoted. To the extent we could, we welcomed the faithful. To the extent we could not, we put the Mass and the message of the gospel on live streaming and other methods of communications. We found ways to come together. We found ways to reconfigure our lives. And I think this will help us going forward, both as a society and as a church.
You yourself were very quickly present in the digital world, both in the administration of the Archdiocese, as we were lots of Zoom meetings together during these months, but your video messages to the faithful on a regular basis and celebrating Mass virtually.
And you know, I as I did that, I sort of thought about the Acts of the Apostles, and I thought about how back in the days of the Roman Empire, those first apostles and their co-workers, the disciples, used what they had, the roads of the Roman Empire, the trade routes, the sea lanes, and they went to the ends of the earth as conceived back then with the message of the gospel. We're essentially doing the same thing. Even when there's limitations about coming together in person in our churches, we're using live streaming, we're using videos, we're using, Lord only knows, Zoom. And we're using these and other technologies to convey the good news, the message of the gospel, the heart of the gospel, which is the life, death, and resurrection of Jesus Christ. And thank the dear Lord that we've been able to do this as much as we can, and reaching not only people who come to church every Sunday, but reaching people who, for whatever reason, have become inactive. The mission is to bring the gospel, to open minds and hearts to the person of Jesus Christ and what he did to save us. And then everything that means in terms of what we believe and teach, how we worship, and how we live. Life has changed. People live and communicate differently. They process information differently, a point I make in my pastoral letter. We need to use these technologies nimbly to meet people where they are at. Pope Francis says that we must accompany one another as together we encounter the Lord. These technologies are ways in which we will continue to accompany one another as we move forward. What we have at our disposal now is a whole new set of tools we're comfortable with for the sake of spreading the gospel.
Absolutely. Finally, you know, as we start to emerge more and more to and resume more of our normal activities and a normal kind of living, none of us has the ability to predict exactly what that timeline's going to look like, but it's clear that the vaccine process is essential in all of that. I know you've been vaccinated, I've been vaccinated as well. What would you say as a message to the faithful who are still anticipating it or might be apprehensive about the vaccine?
I would certainly encourage everyone to receive the vaccine. I was grateful to be able to receive it. It freed me up to do an awful lot of things in my own life and ministry. It is, I think, something good to do for oneself, but it's an act of love for your families, your loved ones, your co-workers, your fellow parishioners, and the larger society, because the more of us who become vaccinated, the sooner this pandemic is going away, and the sooner we can open up our churches without restriction. Won't it be wonderful when we can sing again? Won't it be wonderful when we can take the blue tape up off the floor? Won't it be wonderful again when we could give one another the sign of peace?
Archbishop, thank you very much for your time today.